So how's things so far? What's your initial feeling?
My initial feeling, I feel great. I'm just glad the season is here, and I can't wait to play with my new teammates.
Have you had a chance to work out with them? How long have you been in LA? I've
been in LA since August 9th. My son started kindergarten, so we've been here since then. So, and I've been here with the guys working out. So I mean, it's been great this summer.
What struck you about Lonzo so far in your
workouts? Just his work ethic, man. He's a young kid that have a great work ethic. He works hard in what he do. He try to improve every day, in the weight room and on the court.
What surprised you about just the attention to the Lakers and to Lonzo as well in the city?
It's a lot of attention, just for one person. So, I mean, hey, he brings a lot of attention to this team and for himself and for this organization. And the fans are dialed into it as well. So, I mean, I think we're just going to try to use that excitement to play this year. I mean, keep the crowd behind us.
But can you understand how that could be a distraction, all the attention around Lonzo?
I mean, it could. I mean, but... As a leader on this team, I'll try to keep him focused.
You seem like a relatively low-key kind of personality. That's my opinion, anyway. Is it hard to maintain that in Los Angeles? Has your life changed at all, or is it?
No, I haven't changed much besides the weather. But I mean, I'm always not. What I'm trying to say is, I'm not a vocal. Speaker or whatever, I'm just gonna speak with my actions. So just becoming taking on this new role as a leader, it's been ups and downs, but I'm taking it on and just finding different ways to talk to guys, and different way to approach them, and not approach them and just approach them all at once.
Did you guys do anything like any protests or anything like that during the anthem at all during the season?
No, not that I know of. No, I don't think we did.
What did you think about the way the NFL players reacted to President saying they should be fired if they did that?
I mean, they have a voice. I mean, they're speaking out. I mean, I just think that if they stand behind each other and just stand behind one another, continue to protect each other.
Have you guys started talking amongst yourselves about doing something, making any kind of statement?
No, we haven't talked about it yet, but as a team, we're going to discuss that situation, and when we do, we're going to come up with a solution and see what we do.
Would you be in favor of doing something like that?
Yeah, I mean, if my teammates are behind me and the organization is behind me, yeah, I would, you know what I'm saying? And as far as an individual, I mean, I do have an opinion, and I think what President is doing right now is I don't agree with it. So, I mean, but that's him, and he has his own opinions as well.
Is that a hard thing to, because it's so divisive, is that a hard thing to talk about?
It is hard, but I mean, some people feel more comfortable speaking with it, and some people don't.
People keep talking about the number of guys that were in here throughout the offseason, and the energy, and how hard people are working, even in like September or August. Has that stood out to you at all? I know you've been around the facility.
It did stand out. I mean, there was a lot of guys here every day, even on the weekends. I just come in and try to get treatment. So there was a lot of guys here just working and just continuing to try to get better for this season. And I didn't even realize Coach had to lock the gym up to keep guys out. So, I mean, that was surprising to me. And I like it. I like guys that come in and try to work and get better each and every day.
As someone with a reputation as a good wing defender, what do you think about Brandon Ingram's potential on that side of the ball?
Man, he's got great potential. I mean, I know he can be a great defender on the wing. He just gotta believe in himself. So I mean, as a leader, I'm just gonna push him to that, and just stay on him.
What do you think he can, you know, where can he make the biggest strides on that side? Is it footwork? Is it muscle? Where?
I mean, you always got room to improve on any, like, everything. So, I mean, a little bit of footwork, a little bit of little strength. So, he got the length. So, I mean, he can contest, like, any guard. So, I mean, he got to just have that quickness and that strength.
What players are running those workouts over the summer? Or were you guys just kind of coming in?
We were just coming in. I mean, but every day everybody was here. Mostly everybody was here. So, I mean, we had guys were here like at 7 a.m. Some was coming in like early as 7. So, I mean, it was just a great feeling just walking in the gym to see guys like actually working and not just sitting around and just waiting.
Is this different than the culture you had previously?
I would think it's the same. I mean, but just, I mean, here it was just different. And my guy was in just working hard, like staying late, coming back in. So, I mean, it just felt good just to see that.
Why do you think they're doing that? What reasons why?
I mean, some guys, just want to just so that they can be here, you know, so that they have improved, and they just want to show that they are hard working and they can compete.
Rob Plinka said that Brandon's kind of quiet, and that Lonzo has kind of a quiet demeanor, and we already kind of addressed that maybe you're not necessarily a huge vocal leader as far as that. Who do you think will be the loudest voice, the one that's going to be barking the most out of these guys?
I would say Brandon. I mean, I've seen in practice, while we working out and stuff, like he actually like yelling like guys like to work harder. You know, like I can see him like being more of that type of role.
How many of these guys did you know before you got here? I mean, apart from playing against, how many did you have like the first impression?
I mean. I knew Julius, like we, somewhere from close to the same town. So I mean, but other than that, like just made friends over the years. I played against them.
Have you felt like it's been easy to get to know this group?
Yeah, I mean I know most of them through friends, and actually hung out with a couple of them. So I mean, it was pretty much easy to just walk in and just be myself and not just. Try to get to know somebody here.
Is defense about effort or is it about skill?
Mainly by effort. I mean, you got to give that effort and you got to have that motor to just keep playing defense. Right? So you got to be willing to give more than one effort.
Is it something that can be infectious? People
feed off each other. Yeah, I think it can. Like, one person they see playing defense, next person might start playing defense. I mean, I think it'd be contagious.
What excites you most about being a
Laker? It's a great organization to play for. I mean, I'm blessed to have an opportunity to be here.
Kentavious, there's a perception because of who your representation is that you may have a hand in helping lure LeBron here in another year. I know you're on a 1-year deal, but do you think there's going to be some of that going on?
I don't know anything about that.
Yeah, absolutely not.
Me and my agent talks strictly about basketball and what I need to do for this season.